The Mullingar Flaw will be never forgot by those who were there and by those who were not. The crack it was good and the music was grand, the jigs and the reels and the songs of our land.
Good afternoon, everyone. We're here in front of St. Mary's College, formerly CBS School, and we're here because 70 years ago this year, Cultus Cultori Éireann, CCE, was founded, and it was founded here in Mullingar, and of course the Flá Ceoil na hÉireann will be coming back in all its glory to Mullingar, not this year as we had hoped, but in 2022. And the very first All-Ireland Flá Ceoil under the auspices of Cultus took place in Mullingar in May 1951, 70 years ago this week. And here behind me, St. Mary's CBS was one of the main venues for the first All-Ireland Flá Ceoil. We expect that when the Flá comes to Mullingar in 2022, up to 500,000 people or more will come to it. When it was last here in 1963, at least 70,000, possibly as many as 100,000 attended. The crowd who came here in May 1951 was not quite so large. It's estimated to have been perhaps around 400. But it was a significant event in the town's history. Here behind me is the school, and of course the Christian Brothers had long been great supporters and enthusiasts for Irish culture. The Flá Ceoil, when it started here in 1951, was not actually the first Irish cultural event to have happened in this area. Way back in 1904, the Mullingar Fesh, which then became the Midland Fesh, had been organised by the local Gaelic League and other Irish music and language enthusiasts, and it took place here in St. Mary's College and in what was then a large open field where the present-day primary school building and grounds are now. So that Cultus Flá in 1951, the organisation had just been founded in February of that year by local enthusiasts and members of the Dublin Pipers Club who came down to Mullingar. The prime movers here in Mullingar included Kathleen and Eamon Moynihan. Miss Moynihan ran a business on the main street in Oliver Plunkett Street and her husband Eamon was the principal of Gainstown National School where my own grandmother was teaching at that time. And the original idea of the meeting was to take place in the Moynihan's home, but so many turned up that they instead moved it to the Midland Hotel in Mount Street. And that is where the very first meeting of what became Cultus Cultori Éireann took place. And 3 months later, around which weekend, they organised the first Flá Ceoil. And musicians came from Dublin, but also from around Mullingar and the locality. There is a wonderful photograph showing an elderly lady dancing with an Ilan Piper, who I believe is a member of the Seary family from out near Castletown and Dysart, playing. Among the competitors who won medals at that first Flá was a man who would go on to play a very distinguished role in the musical history of Mullingar, Hubert McGee, who was for half a century the director of Mullingar Town Band. And he is one of the relatively few surviving medalists from that first All-Ireland Flá. So a great musical tradition which has began in this town. And that's what was emphasised when the committee was set up to try and bring the Flá to Mullingar for the first time in more than half a century, bringing it back home. This is where it all began, in Mullingar in 1951, the founding of an organisation which has now spread across all continents. Wherever you have Irish people in large numbers, you have branches of Cultus Cultori Éireann. And it was the very name Cultus was given to it by Eamon Moynihan. They had been using another name, I think Common, but there was already an organisation with that name, so it was Eamon Moynihan who suggested calling it Cultus called Tori Aaron. And that very small beginning here in Mullingar, in the CBS, and just down the street from here in St Mary's Hall, marked the beginning of what has now become one of the largest musical events in the Irish calendar, one of the largest, indeed, traditional musical events anywhere in the world. An event that over the years has grown steadily in the numbers attending, from the hundreds here in the 50s to the tens of thousands and now into the hundreds of thousands. It hasn't been possible to stage the FLA in 2020 or this year, but it is coming back to where it all began in 2022. And so this week we mark the 70th anniversary of that very first Cultus Cultori Éireann All-Ireland FLA, FLA Ciol na Héireann, on the 13th and 14th of May 1951. Thank you. We're standing now outside St Mary's Hall, St Mary's Training Centre it is now, one of the most historic buildings in Mullingar and a great entertainment venue for many, many decades. And this was one of the venues used for the very first All-Ireland FLA Ciol na Héireann, which took place 70 years ago this month in 1951. Not very many people were at the FLA in 51 compared with the numbers who would come in subsequent years. So the main venues they used were St Mary's College and here St Mary's Hall. And St Mary's Hall already had interesting historical connections to the Irish cultural movement back in 1902 when the Mullingar branch of the Gaelic League was set up. The inaugural meeting was attended by a member of the central branch of the Gaelic League from Dublin, and that person was actually Patrick Pearse. So Patrick Pearse actually addressed a meeting in this hall, gave a talk on the importance of the language back in 1902. And it was used for some musical events during the Midland Fesh through the decades in the 1900s up through the 1940s. So when the All-Ireland FLA took place in 1951, this was one of the venues used by the musicians, by the reciters and the other competitors. And it was at a meeting in this hall in 1952, the inaugural meeting where Cultus was founded had taken place in the Midland Hotel, but there was a subsequent meeting, really their first AGM in 1952, and it was at that point that the name became Cultus Cultori Éireann, the name having been suggested by Eamon Moynihan, principal of Gainstown National School. And that was at a meeting in this hall. And again, the hall was used as a venue in 1963 when the All-Ireland FLA returned to the town in which Cultus had actually been founded, the town in which it all began. And the hall was used as one of the venues for the musical events in the FLA of 1963, which took place on the June bank holiday weekend that year and was attended by 70 to 100,000 people. And just to mention another Irish cultural connection, in 1953 there was a major event held throughout Ireland called An Tástáil, which was really a celebration of Ireland. It was meant primarily as a tourist promotion exercise. Events took place in every town and city, and one of the events which took place here during the Tástáil of 1953 was a lecture on Irish history given by Helena Maloney, actress, member of the Abbey Theatre Company, trade unionist, a 1916 veteran. She'd served in the garrison at City Hall with the Irish Citizens Army during the Rising. So she actually spoke in that hall. May also mention that James Joyce would have attended plays and concerts in the hall here during his period in Mullingar in 1900 and 1901. It was one of the major entertainment venues in the town. Now it's a training centre, but we hope that a plaque will be put up sometime, perhaps as part of the FLA celebrations next year, to mark the connections between this hall and people like Patrick Pearse, and the fact that it was one of the venues used for the very first Fla Ceoil and for some of the earliest meetings of Comhaltas Ceoil Tóirí Éireann in 1951 and 1952, and was used in 1963 as one of the venues during the All-Ireland Fla that year. Thanks very much. We're standing now outside what was Moynihan's house, Mulready's drapery store, and this is where Eamon and Kathleen Moynihan lived, among the founding members of Comhaltas Ceoil Tóirí Éireann back in 1951. And the meeting which led to the setting up of Comhaltas was actually meant to take place in the building behind me here, the Moynihan shop and house. But plans didn't go quite according to how they had been planned out, because far more people arrived down from Dublin and elsewhere for the meeting than they could actually hold in a house which was full of children. The Moynihans had 7 children, and she was running a business as well. So the meeting was relocated from here to the Midland Hotel in Mount Street, which is now Columbia Bar. But the plaque behind me here commemorates these people who were such key players in the founding of what has become one of Ireland and indeed the world's largest cultural organisations, Comhaltas Ceoil Tóirí Éireann, because it was Cóth and Eamon Moynihan were there from the very beginning running the organisation. As it was Eamon who came up with the name Comhaltas, Comhaltas Ceoil Tóirí Éireann, and they were there to help to organise the very first Fla Ceoil in May 1951, and were involved in the organisation of the Fla and the growth of Comhaltas in the years ahead. And Eamon Moynihan sadly died at quite a young age in 1961, but his wife Cóth, who went on with her involvement with Comhaltas, and was involved again in helping to organise the 1963 Fla Ceoil in June of that year, with the street here in 1963 would have been absolutely jammed with people. So a plaque was put up in 2018 to mark the important role that this place here, this building, what was then Mulready's drapery store, played in the founding of Comhaltas Ceoil Tóirí Éireann. And this 70 years on, we remember Eamon and Cóth Moynihan and the huge work they did and their enormous contribution to Irish cultural history here in Mullingar. As I said, this is where it all began, this organisation which has now spread worldwide and which is expected to bring 500,000 people to this town when the Fla returns in 2022. But it all started here with an idea by the people in this house behind me here. Thank you. And Cóth, despite running a business or drapery shop that was here in the building behind us and raising 7 children, also found the time to help get Comhaltas up and running in 1951, and also was its first national chairperson, and is to date the only female chairperson in the 70 years of Comhaltas' history. The Moynihan sons, Éadan and Colmoin, were also involved with Comhaltas at local and national level over many years, and Colmoin remains one of the national trustees of Comhaltas Ceoil Tóirí Éireann. The next generation has also become involved, because the granddaughter of Eamon and Cóth, Aoife Moynihan, serves on the Mullingar Fla Committee, whose work helped bring the Fla Ceoil back to Mullingar, back to where it all began. And of course the Fla Ceoil will be held in Mullingar in 2022. So to the Moynihans, Mullingar owes a huge debt of gratitude for all they've done for this town's cultural life and indeed for the national cultural life of our country.